How to remove toxic people from your life? If you think of that question, or if you're plagued by that question, then this video is for you. I remember that I used to face difficulty to, take out these toxic thoughts or toxic people from my life. So I learned some techniques and I started cleansing my mind, and that's what I'm going to share with you today, and I'm guaranteeing that it will help if you start implementing it in your life. All right, so watch this video completely till the end to understand the three secrets to remove toxic people and toxic thoughts from your head. All right, watch this video completely till the end. Namaste, I'm Sachin Hebbar, creator of Self Healers Hub, on a mission to help 100,000 working professionals live a healthier, happier, and a more energetic life through the ancient Indian science of Ayurveda. And Ayurveda says health is an integration of body, mind, and soul. Okay, so you have to understand that. So let's begin today's tutorial on how to remove toxic people from your life right now. Let's not waste any more time. Type bring it on in the comment box, or type ready to start in the comment box. RTS, type RTS in the comment box and let me share my screen right now. Type RTS in the comment box. Yes. Okay, let me share my screen now. Okay, so we have three secrets and then a surprise offer. All right, surprise gift, I would say. Yeah, so let's stay till the end. Okay, so first secret. What is the first secret to understand what and how to remove toxic people? Let's begin this right now. First one, you have to understand this. Whenever people are hurting you, or you're seeing them as toxic, you have to understand hurt people, or people who are frustrated take out their frustration on you, or people who are sad take out their sadness on you. Hurt people, please understand this. If someone is being toxic to you, or you feel that they're toxic, or you feel that it's a toxic relationship in my life, it only means that person is hurt. Hurt people. So be a little mature and understand why that hurt is coming inside them. Try to get that first. All right, and that will help you reduce the toxicity of your relationship, or reduce the level of toxic relationships in your life by understanding that hurt people. Yes, type in the comment box HP HP. Hurt people. Okay, you have to understand this, and then only you will know that why that toxicity is coming. A particular relationship or people does not become toxic like that. It is because something has gone wrong, and that you have to understand by speaking and by communicating and by understanding. Okay, so hurt people. And next, let's move on to the next one now. Why do you process the toxic thoughts? You see, we may have seen this. What would have happened is, someone would have scolded you on the road, or someone in your relationships has scolded you, someone has told something to you, and you feel bad emotions towards that person. You feel, oh, why did they say that to me? Oh, why did he scold me? Am I not good enough? You start feeling these, and your mind picks that up. Your mind picks that up. When the mind picks that up, again and again, the problem starts. It keeps on repeating, oh, am I not good enough? Oh, why did they scold me? And you start processing the toxic thoughts. So what happens is, if you have a relationship, you have a close relationship, okay, you have a close relationship, please pay attention here. Then what happens? You are not going and looking at the good things of that relationship. Now you are only processing the toxic thoughts, and that's the nature of the human mind. It will always process the negativity easily. Okay, so now you have a relation and you feel that it's toxic, or the toxic people, but you may already would have good memories with them. But when you only process the toxicity or the bad things of a relationship, what will happen? The bad thing grows, the good things is overlooked. You will not be able to see the good things at all because you're processing only the toxic thoughts. Is it powerful? Type powerful in the comment box. You're only focusing on the toxic things which has happened, so that's made the toxic relationship. That's it. And this is the very powerful thing what I want to share in this first one is who occupies your mind. See this here in the down. Who occupies your mind? See, someone would have scolded you, or someone, then you will feel like, oh my God, I want to take revenge on this guy. I want to give it back to him somehow. Then what happens? In that state of mind, what you will do is you will start processing and thinking how to harm him, how to take that revenge on him, how to, you know, take the revenge or do something, how to give it back to him or her. I don't know. Then you start processing that. What will happen is you will start becoming that toxic person you are trying to avoid, or you will start becoming that toxic person because you are processing how to, you know, take the revenge or get it back from that. Are you getting my point? Who occupies your mind is very, very important. Now, if you letting that person's revenge occupy your mind will keep on processing such thoughts itself. Yes, and when your mind starts processing such thoughts, you start attracting such people only in your life. How do I? And when you go, you're there, and people who are that kind will start getting attracted to you. So, you have to understand this. So, first and foremost, please understand it's written here who occupies your mind. You have to be very careful of this. Okay, don't process revenge or that, process forgiveness. And leave it. That's it. Don't process how to hurt him or how to give it back to him. How to take the revenge. If you keep processing that, you will become that person which you wanted to avoid. All right. Please be careful of this. So make sure who occupies your mind is very important. Okay. Don't give your mind for rent so easily. Okay. Don't give your mind for rent so easily. So make sure of this. Okay. Next, let's move on to the next secret now. So understand, hurt people. Why are you processing the toxic thoughts and who occupies your mind? This is the first basic. You have to understand this to remove the toxic people from your life. Okay. Why a particular person becomes toxic? Hurt people. Why do you process toxic thoughts? Why are you allowing that thoughts to be processed in your mind? It's like that Mission Impossible movie. It's a mission if you choose to accept it. Correct? It's your mission if you choose to accept it, right? Similar way, why are you choosing to process the toxic thoughts about a person? Rather, focus on the good things which has happened in the person. And finally, if you are processing the thoughts of revenge and giving it back to him or her, and then you start becoming that person. You start becoming the enemy which you want to avoid. So you have to be careful of that. Okay? So this is the first secret. All right, guys? So what is the second one? Let's reveal it now. Type ready to learn. Type RTL in the comment box. Okay. Now, let me tell you what happens here. What is this too many cars? You might be wondering. So understand this. You see, the problem is these days, we are having a lot of relationships due to the emergence of social media. Yes, that is there. You have to accept it. It's a reality. But understand this, guys. Let's take the vehicle example. Will you have a lot of cars in your home? You'll have one car. You'll have two cars maximum. Yeah. You take the example of this. And what happens when you get out or go on a bus or a train? You get in, you get out. You get in, you get out. Correct? You get in and you get out. But if you have a lot of cars in your home, what will happen? Lot of tension, no? Oh, I want to take care of that car's maintenance, this car's maintenance, every maintenance. So directly your peace is directly proportional to the number of cars you have in your life, something like that. Okay. So here the cars mean the relationship. How many close relationships you have? See, when you have a lot of close relationships, each one of that will affect you. Okay, so when you have a lot of relationship, what will happen? One or two, three close relationships become toxic, and they become toxic people in your life, and you cannot get out of that. Why? Because they become toxic now. They are close relation. Too many cars. You can't give away that car. So what you have to do? You have to keep your social circle small. Make sure of they only have a little bit of close friends, close relatives. close family members. Only make sure you have less number of cars. Don't have too many number of cars. And others, how do I, hey, are you telling do not socialize? No, I'm not telling that. What you need to do? You think like a bus or a train, get in, get out, like a hi, bye, be cordial, that's it. If you do like that, then it's okay. Have fun. What do you do in a bus? When you go on a bus ride, you have fun? No, you'll have fun and then you get out, get down at your stop, that's it. On the train as well, you just enjoy the scenery and all that and then get down the train, that's it, the journey has ended. Similar way you do that with all the others, but your close circle, do not have a very big close circle, because even if one close person becomes changes, becomes toxic, it's a problem for you. Is it not? That's the power here. So this is the how to remove the toxic people from your life. Second, don't have too many close relationships, have only little bit of close relationships. Finally, next, understand this. Garbage in, garbage out. Let me show that to you. Yeah, GIGO, garbage in, garbage out. If you say it in our coding words, it's like first in, first out, right? Similar way, garbage in, garbage out. So what are you seeing daily and day out? Understand that. You have to audit that. If you audit that, you'll understand why toxic people are coming into your life. Because you're consuming garbage, you're attracting such people only. So can you start doing an audit? Yes? Can you do that? If yes, type in the comment, okay? If you're going to do that, do a cleanup. Do an audit of what you're seeing. So garbage in, garbage out. And understand, many people are frustrated. We already saw in the first secret. Hurt people, right? Now some hurt people, some frustrated people will, you know, come and throw some garbage on you. They will say something, okay? Then you will take that garbage. Will you take that garbage and move across the full day and attract such things only in that day? Or do you will just leave that away? You have to understand that. So this is how what happens is someone may have put some garbage on top of you and now you want to take that smell and keep full day, and that full day someone will get attracted to you. Only people who like garbage will keep attracting to you. Or what will happen in your home also will take out in that way. And what will happen? That relation start becoming toxic. If you keep doing it over and over again, this is the problem. Do not become a garbage dump. Somebody told you something and now you take that and you keep it and allow that fragrance of garbage to be coming from you. And that's what everyone will sense. That's how your body language will change. That's how your tone will change. That is very first and foremost, don't have too many cars. Second, it's written here, GIGO, garbage in, garbage out. Third, do not become a garbage dump, which is very, very important. Okay, I hope this is clear, right? Type CC in the comment box, type CC. CC is crystal clear, okay? Next, what is the secret number three? This is a very nice one, books and environment, okay? Books and environment. So what kind of books you read and what kind of environment you keep? You see, you're an average of 5 people you are with. So understand this, too many cars, right? That cars, bus and train. So car needs to be, you need to keep that cars very carefully, choose those cars very carefully. Yes, are you understanding my point? If you have a good circle of cars, you do not have good circle of close relationships, then you have a good environment who are trying to push you, who are going to make you grow, then it's good. What kind of books do you read? That's also very important. To keep your mind cleansed, it's like a temple, so keep it cleansed so that when you are cleansed, you attract such people only in your life. When you become a garbage dump or you process toxic thoughts, you are automatically becoming like that. Yes? Thank you, Muthulakshmi, for that. Thank you. Thank you for the comment. All right. So this is what it is. When you become like that, start going into the garbage dump or process the toxic thoughts, you will attract such people only. Then you will think, why there is toxic relationship in my life? Because you are emitting toxicity. Please understand that. Your body language is showing toxicity. This is the thing. No need to think so much. This is the root cause. Remove the root cause, everything will be okay. And finally, you need to have a guru or mentor, anyone in your life. Don't be directionless. That's a very problematic issue when it starts. It can be your parents. It can be another mentor. I don't know who it is, whom you resonate with. But you have to have a guru. Don't be directionless. And that happens, very big problem. When you do that, you easily run into toxic people who can easily influence you. So don't make that. Have a guru in your life. It can be anyone. I am not saying it. Do go follow only this, follow only that. No. Have a good, let it be your parents, or okay, like that, so that you are protected from the toxicity. That's it. That's what I want to say here. So let me just recap all the three things for you guys. Three important points. Okay. First, you have to be careful who occupies your mind. So if you're processing negative thoughts, or if you're processing thoughts of revenge, or if you're processing thoughts of, how to get back at him or her, then a problem comes. Then you start emitting toxicity. You have to understand, hurt people hurt people. If someone is hurting you or throwing toxic things at you, you have to understand that person is hurt and try to find out why he's hurt. And that will reduce your toxicity. Second, garbage in, garbage out. Again, garbage in, garbage out. You have to understand, again and again you are processing. If someone told something bad to you, oh he told bad, and then you keep that, take it out on your family, take it out on your friends, everything, garbage in, garbage out, right? Let me open up the mind map as well for everyone to see here. Yes. And finally, you have to understand, don't have too many cars in your life. Have only little number of cars, so that relationships are close, relationships should be less, your social and others you keep as like a bus or a train. Okay, have a good cordial relationship, and once the journey has ended, get down on your stop. That's it. Have it like a bus or train, and don't have too many cars in your life. When you have too many cars, again, if one car becomes problem, maintenance karna hai, sab karna hai, sab problem ho jayega. Don't do that. Okay, avag sa problem shuru aagata, le problem shuru aagata. So be careful of that, and make sure you are understanding. And finally, books and environment. Let's put that here. Books and environment. Okay, what kind of books you read and what kind of company you keep. You are an average of five persons you are with. So what kind of company you keep and what kind of books you read, and do you have a guru? Do you have a direction in your life? Make a guru. It can be anyone, parents, mentor, coaches. Make sure you do that. Why? Because guru or a person will tell you if something mistake has done, they will tell you, no, don't do that. That's the power of a mentor, coach or a guru. Okay, because they would have done some mistake and they will guide you not to do that mistake. It can be in any area. Okay, so make sure you are, if you see people who are growing a lot, they generally have mentors, coaches, or they have a guru. That's it. Okay, if you see that, if you study people, they have a guru. The guru can be a book also. It can be a book also. Yes, it can be a book also. So understand that. Yes, and if you want to remove this toxicity all from your life, and you need to clear your emotional cleansings. You have to become emotional, you know, clean your emotions, clear your mental blockages. Yes, and that's what I exactly do in my gut detox program. That is what I do in my gut detox program. I speak about and I make you do a guided meditation where I can help you clear out so many mental blockages. Okay, so how do I go get into that? You may be thinking, how do I get into that? You can go to this link. Just go to this link. I'm going to put that down here. Just go to this link, which is there, bit.ly/gutdetox. I'm going to put that in this also. Just go to that link and give in your details, and you will understand the process. Watch the video, what you're going to learn there. Go to this link, bit.ly/gutdetox, and you'll understand what you're going to learn and everything. And this will help you accelerate your stress and immunity. All right. So if you, this is what was this today's tutorial on how to make sure that you remove toxic people from your life by eliminating the toxicity inside you. All right. So this was the tutorial for today. And if you loved that, hit that love symbol. Okay. Hit that love symbol on Facebook. And if you're watching this on YouTube, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button there, hit that subscribe button. And if you really loud, that post it on your wall. Post it on your wall. Okay, share it on your wall. Let it at least for your friends give a lot of value. All right, share it. Post it on your wall. Pay it forward. All right. So thank you so much for tuning in for this tutorial. Thank you to everyone who watched it completely till the end. Loving you all so much. Let's meet in the next tutorial. Bye bye. Take care. Stay healthy. Stay immune. Stay happy. Loving you all so much. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Thank you.